Hello to all my jazz students. So today we're gonna do things a little bit different. We're not gonna have a beginner and a senior jazz. We're gonna kind of do a general jazz class, but we're gonna do two different styles of jazz. So we're gonna start off with a warm-up. Now the warm-up is gonna be the same on both videos. So what I'd recommend is that you do one jazz class one day and another jazz class another day. The warm-up's gonna be a typical jazz warm-up. It's gonna involve lots of technical elements, turning out, using square hips, all of that kind of stuff. And then we're going to learn two different types of routines, and this is where the different videos will come into play. So in one style, we're going to do a lyrical jazz and keep it quite contemporary. And in the other style, in the other video, it's going to be an up-tempo jazz, more like a show number. And a bit cheesy, a bit of fun. So we have the two different styles of jazz. And the reason I've decided to do that is actually because watching kind of who's been watching the videos, it's the senior jazz has been kind of more popular. And I think a few of the juniors are trying the senior ones anyways. So I figured actually, why not? Let's just all do the same routines, the same classes, but actually do two different styles of jazz. So anyone that saw the finale number in the show, that Hey Pachuco number, that is up tempo jazz. So that's going to be kind of the style of one of the videos. All right, so we're going to start off with a warm up. Now, like I said, the warm up's going to be the same both times. So do them on different days. All right, okay, so make sure you've got a nice big space where you can stand, not touch anybody or anything else. Make sure you're doing this video with just other people in your own household. And then I'd like you to just copy me, okay? So not going into cardio, going straight into just keeping things nice and relaxed. Okay, let's do a bit late bird. So lift up, head to the side. Shoulder, head roll forward, and up. Head up. We're going to take our shoulders side to side. And forward, and up and back. Forward, ribs, side, center. Forward and back. Okay, we're gonna go round and side forward, side back. And change. Round and double. Change. Hit. Forward and back. Big circles. And change. Figure of eight. Change direction. Good. Right, feet into first position. We're going demi-plie. So nice strong arm. And full plie. Tendu, second. And we're gonna hold it down there. Up into the demi point. And balance. Now if you need to lower your heels, that's fine. Rock side to side. Stay on your big toe. Flat like a table. And demi plie. Circle up. Permanently. Again. Okay, we're gonna go for your feet. And up, up, down, down. Change. Through your feet.
in a circle, keep this parallel. So keep your knee pointing forward. Keep it pointing forward. Back down. And switch. And bring it back round. Right, we're going to go into our tonsures. Glissades, and our rondeaux. Okay, so first position. Arms in the bar. Okay. We're going to keep our hands on our hips. Rotate, rotate, demi-plié, and point, and in, using that floor, so push through the floor, rotate, rotate, demi-plié, and back, to the back. Demi-plié, other side. Rotate. Plié. And back. Demi-plié. Good. Okay, we're going to take it off the ground now. So no higher than 45 degrees. Using those turnout muscles. Really using that foot to bring it back to the tonsure. Just through the floor. Oh, don't lose your balance. Rotate, rotate, because I wasn't pulling up. Demi-plié. So bring up nice and tall on this supporting leg. Rotate, rotate, demi-plié. And to the second. Keep pulling up here. That's why I lost my balance before, I stopped pulling up. So this side, the side you're standing on, make it as tall as you can. Okay, even on your plié, keep pulling up tall. Good, down. It's like you're zipping yourself up. Okay, and one jump. Open to the second. And close. And reverse it. So demi-plié. We're going to go around to second, and close. Other side, and. So do that turn out, keep everything square. Keep those arms rounded, or see your legs up, be naughty today. Okay, we're going to do tour de bras forward. So, keep your legs straight, down to the ground, bring it up. And we're going to pull the bra back, it's just a high release. Open, so your hips shouldn't move. Okay, we're going to tonsure for a second. Over. Through the first. And coming up. And in. Good. Okay, just give your legs a bit of a shake out, your arms a bit of a shake out. Okay, so. What we're going to do is we're going to carry on with our floor bar. Same principles apply. I want square hips. So we're just going to go over some of the movements, just because there are a few new people joining us and things, where it's a new block of classes. So we're going to go over some of the movements, talking about our square hips and where they need to be in our placement and body alignment. We need to really think about the fact that when we're pulling up, when we're zipping up, and when we're stood up in our tonsures, that if we are doing this and dropping into our hip, then that whole exercise becomes pointless. So when I'm saying pulling up, what I mean is, so if I'm using this leg, if this is my working leg, so this is the one doing all the movements, then this leg needs to become long and tall. My weight needs to be on the ball of my foot. I need to be pulling my body up It's like there's a piece of string and it's like zipped you all the way up nice and tall. And you're trying to almost lift off your foot whilst pushing into the ground. So this foot is then free to move without you falling over. Now, when I had my little wobble to the back, it's because I was not really focusing on what I should have been doing and trying to tell you what to do. And by doing that, it meant that I'd basically just been a bit lazy, let myself go. So I lost my balance. So I needed to keep pulling back up on that hip. So it's really important that you remember to do that. And also that we remember the floor is our friend in dance. We want to use it. We don't want to lift from our quads. We want to push underneath the back of these muscles here to push through the floor. Push through the floor, not lift up from here. Okay, push from behind. And that's how we get lovely lines, good technique, and strong positions. And it's the same when we go onto the floor, which is why I really like a floor bar, because a floor bar helps you to work correctly. So when we're on our fronts and we're doing our work to the back, just move back so you can see, when we're doing our work to the back, the important thing is that both hips are on the floor and that you're turned out. So not like this, with your legs turned in and horrible sickled feet. Point and heels towards each other. So when you're lifting, you're turned out, okay? I don't mind if you want to have your back slightly up, as long as your tummy is on the floor. So not this, okay? Tummy must be down. Your hands can be here. I don't mind. Okay, when you go to the back, every single time we do that retire position, every single time this knee turns out to the side, okay, not up to the front, out to the side. Even when we extend our leg to the front, we bring the knee back. So we're trying to work our turn out muscles, okay. Now you get those lifts. So if I'm doing this, I'm not working my turn out muscles, I'm working my quads, okay. So I want to turn out here, and then from my knee I'm extending forwards and up, all right? I'm not letting this hip come off the floor, not twisting or letting this hip, like you'll see it better on this side. If you let this hip come off the floor like that, or your knee bend, then you've lost your technique. So everything needs to stay, try to glue it to the floor, stay tight to the floor, and we go side, 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 in front, side, 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 back down. That's when we do our ones to the front. Then we do our legs to extend into the side. That's even easier. But just don't let that hip go. Keep that down. Yeah, that's the tricky bit on that bit. So think about your supporting leg. When we come to our beats here, I want a 90. Try not to be here. 90 degrees. We open to the fullest second that we have, keeping that 90 degree angle. Beat, open, beat, open. Now I change my legs which way I beat each time, just because it makes me feel like I'm working more evenly, but that is up to you. Our last section, our pliés, from here, hands on top of your knees. I'm gonna have to move, I keep kicking the flowers. Hands on top of your knees, lead with your heels to come in and lead with your toes to come out, okay? All right, so nice and slow, nice controlled movements. We're then going to just finish really, really simply. I'm just wondering whether to make you do some hips. No, we'll save that. That's going to be in the acro, the hips and the strong arms and all that. But we will finish with a little bit of core conditioning, and we'll just finish with a plank hold like we have done before, okay? So floor bar is all about working your rotation, your turnout, and your alignment. Square hips are everything, okay? And then we'll finish with a plank for our conditioning. All right, and then we save our stretch to the end again. Just gonna have a quick drink. Let's put some music on. So on our tummy, turning out, 8 lifts each side, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, right leg, long leg. 5, 6, 7, 8. Turn it round. And 1. Turn it out, remember? That's how slow we're going. 2. Keep this knee pin down. 3. Just skipping past the nursery rhymes. Okay, ready? Legs up. Five, six, seven, eight. We're doing 16. 1, 2, 3, 4. Control it. 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep that turn out. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, that leg's open. We're going to do 8 pliés with some resistance and hills. Two, so really squeezing everything. She you feel like you're pushing through water. Three. Four. Okay, from here, we're going to just bring them back, okay, towards the ground. Okay, ease in. One knee up, rotate. And switch, we're just relaxing the hips, they've done a lot of work. Okay, turn around, we're going to plank. We're going to go to the end of the music, that's it. Ready? And hold. Keep holding. Nice and warm now, ready to dance. Grab a quick drink and we're going to start on our routine. Hello and welcome back for our up-tempo jazz routine. We're going to be dancing to Young Hearts. It's the Romeo and Juliet version, so it's by Kim Maisel. Young Hearts, Run Free. Okay, so we wait the first two lots of eight, we completely let them go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're going to do a pas de bourrée, right, left, right. So, right, left, right, into a jazz fourth. Okay, so that's turning us to the side. So, one and a two. We do a single pirouette on a fondue. Okay, placing the foot behind, arms open, hip roll, hip roll. Okay, so 5, 6, 7, 8. Right, left, right, turn, stop, sorry, opposite arm, but then you switch it, open, open. Then we go to the other corner, left, right, left, single, stop, hand, hand, to make a star. Okay, so, the rhythm is da 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 da, and that's the pas de bourrée. Da 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 da, turn turn boom, hit run. Da 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 da, turn turn boom, boom boom. Okay, so pas de bourrées. For those of you that haven't done them, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so opposite foot to legs. There's lots of different ways you can pas de bourrée. You can pas de bourrée forwards. You can pas de bourrée backwards. You can pas de bourrée to the side. Okay, but normally it's behind, side, front in jazz. So behind, side, front. So your body has changed to front. Behind, side, front is the normal way you do a pas de bourrée in jazz, okay? So, behind, side, front, single pirouette, drop, hip roll, hip roll. Behind, side, front, single pirouette, drop, no hip roll, hand, hand. Okay, so we're going to just try that with music. Five, six, seven, eight. Pas de bourrée, single turn, drop, roll, roll. Pas de bourrée, single turn, wait, hand, hand. Okay. So are we all okay with that? Pas de bourrée. Ray. One and two. Yeah? Pas de bourrée. Ray. So after you've done that, we come forwards. Step, ball, change, step, ball, change. Okay? So step, ball, change is bum, ba-dum, bum, ba-dum. It's basically a step gallop. We're doing it a little bit salsa-y. So we're going step together, step. And we're doing a slight body roll as we do it. Up, 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 up. Keep it turned out, stay on your demi point. Arms are coming down. Yeah? One and two, three and four. And again, six, seven. Boom, boom. What's the sense in sharing this one and only life? Yeah, is how we're coming forwards. So, if that's a little bit tricky, take out the body roll and just go step, 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 and bring it forwards. Yeah? So, if you want the easy version, you're going to go pas de bourrée. Don't do the turn. So, you'll go pas de bourrée, switch arms, roll, roll, pas de bourrée, no arms, hand, hand, one, two, three, four. The full version, one and two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one and two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one and two, three and four. Okay? Let's go with music up to the... Five, six, seven, and one and two. The next bit. Okay, so one and two, three and four. Circle on your dummy point and hit. I'm just going to move back. Circle and hit. Yeah? So, boom, 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 boom. Step as your legs, arms go out, as your leg goes out. One, two, boom, boom. So that just comes up, turns in, and goes back. Boom, boom, keep the arms bent. Boom, boom. Yeah, so what's the sense in sharing this one only life? Da 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 da. Yes, that's quite quick. One and two, three and four, five, six, seven, and eight. Yeah, and eight. I'm going to carry on from there. Let's just walk out through one more time. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. We push off our front foot, lifting our back leg. So your right leg is going to push forwards, your left leg's going to come up, and you're going to turn, bringing the arm down. So the arm is going to come nearest the camera. One, two, three, four. Okay, they're like a slow motion run, but we're going to turn the leg out, yeah? And the arms are hands rather than fists. Run, run. Okay, we've got two of those to the corner, and they're quite slow. So, one and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. One, two, three, four. We're coming back. Five and six and seven and eight. Okay, as you do that, our arms are coming up into a V and we're body rolling again. Five and six and seven and eight. Okay, but if you don't need to do the body roll, you don't have to. You can just bring your arms up. Five and six and seven and eight. All right. So there's a little tiny hint of some salsa movements in all of these. Even this, if you really wanted to, you could put a bit more hip in. Okay. But it's not. It's still jazz. All right. So let's go again from the top. We're over halfway, we only got the last little bit to add on after that. Five, six, seven, eight. Get ready. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Good. We're going up two. And that's it. That's as far as we're going up to. So we've got the last little bit. So we've just come back. 5, 6, 7, 8. We're taking the leg over to turn us around. And our arms are going to push up to almost like a fifth position, but the palms are on top of each other. So we're going to go 1, 2. Then they're going to drop here, okay? So that foot comes up to the retire and you pivot on your other leg. So this foot does a pivot and this foot just comes up parallel, not turned out. 1, 2, 3. Down here. Now, if you need to go onto the flat, that's fine. From there, you're going straight into a high kick. Optional arms, you can pick your arms. So from there, straight into a high kick. Woo, okay? Now, I don't mind if you ball change it, développé it, whack it. Not whack it, we never whack it. We'll take that out. If you wanna do it straight or if you wanna flick, I don't mind, is what I was trying to say. Okay, so, back 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, I'm gonna ball change into it, and 3, 4. I didn't drop my arms, did I? Sorry. 1, 2, and 3, 4. Into a slide. 5. Okay. And it's just a slow slide to the side. Again, free arms. 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. And then we've just got the last tiny little bit to add on. So we've just gone from the chorus coming forwards, from the verse coming forwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hands are going out opposite. You're going to look at your bottom hand and you're going to limp round. 1, 2, 3, 4, and change. 2, 3, 4. So we're ponying. It's where it's like when you've hurt your ankle and you have to limp. So one side, 2, 3, 4, and swap, 2, 3, 4. So this move is called a pony. Okay, it's like a little pony trotting. And that's as far as we're going up to. Okay, so let's go from the new bit. So come back, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, and 3, 4. You've got time to catch your breath. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that's as far as we're going today. Nothing more than that. So let's do it 2 times with music. We'll have a little recap in the middle and then we'll have our stretch. Okay? Forward, round, and side, run, back, up, round, back, good, 10. Hopefully that all makes sense, okay? So from the beginning, we've got it slow motion. This is the last time we're gonna do it slow, then we're gonna do it one more time music. 1 and 2, pile of red, low 10. 3, 4, swap, 5, 6, roll, 7, 8. 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, so palms turn in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, run. 3, 4, back. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is the whole dance what we've got up to so far. All right, shall we give it a go with music again? Okay. Last time through for today, and then we'll add on some more counts next week. On my slide, on my drugs, but you get the idea. All right, okay, so let's have a cool down and a bit of a stretch. All right, just grab a quick drink. Okay, welcome back for a bit of a stretch. Just want your head over to the side and down to the ground, to the other side, hand on your head. You're going to bring it back over. And both hands on the back, head. And chin towards your chest. And up, other side. Elbows to each side. Inner up. All the way down. And just hang out at the bottom. Circle up. And we're going to change direction. Last one. Up, full back. And one more. Stay down there. Demi-plie. And stretch. Demi-plie. And stretch. Walking around. Holding that stretch, both legs straight, hips square, don't let it open, okay? Into a nice lunge. Make sure that back leg's really straight. Hip into the floor. Lean really down and into that hip. Isn't it strange? And stretch back. You look at me, I look at you, but nothing to say. It and facing me, turning that leg out. Switch. And turning in. Knee down. tune into your hip. And stretch back. Long backs. And stretch both legs out. Keep that square, remember, no opening up. Sliding out into box splits, and we're going to hold it on our elbows. Okay. And sink back into straddle. Arms up, don't let these arms touch the floor at any point. And over. Good, okay. Feet into pipe. Woo! Move forward. And on. Okay, we're going to take one leg in, keep this other one stretched and on the floor, and extend, and plie, and stretch, keep this one pulled out as well, the one on the ground, just pulls your leg, keep pushing that, nice deep breath in, and out, and switch in. Okay, extend. Plie. And extend. Plie. And extend. Good, okay. Coming up, right leg forwards. And into splits. Hold that. And switch. Left leg forwards. Make sure you're square, remember. Back onto our feet. Heels into the ground. And coming up. Just shake everything out. Give your legs a little shake. If you want to do some cobra stretches or some quad stretches, we haven't done them, so feel free to add those in. All right, but I will see you next week. Bye.